So hello, welcome to a new video, probably the last one from 2019. So for this reason I want to make an extra video. I will post this in the Facebook group, which I'll talk about a little bit, and of course on the YouTube channel, because I wanted to talk a little bit about what happened this year, and also give some hints on what I'm working on and what I'm doing. And I will answer some questions which might have been in some of your minds. So at some point somebody asked why I'm sort of, if the background was not real that I was using, because he was seeing some flashes at times. I kind of left that in on purpose because I kind of liked it. It gives sort of a matrix effect that you sometimes see that something is not quite right. But for today I put this animation behind me, which is actually my home cinema room, where I'm experimenting with using projectors and hue lights. So in the background sometimes you see these lights sort of flashing up like now. That's actually part of my work, weirdly enough, and you can sort of see that I'm experimenting in how we could sort of hook up this for different museum sort of systems. Of course in this case I'm using it in a silly way, but you can imagine you can use this in a quite a serious way. So I figured that was kind of nice for today. On the other side of the screen you see something that I do want to talk about a little bit. So if you see this video and you're not part of our Facebook group, so this YouTube channel kind of over the last years have evolved into being companion or dual sort of system with a Facebook group that I partly run, which is called A7, but we now call it the Full Frame Setup Tips for Sony. I will link it in the description. If you're not part of that, please join if you want to. Please also subscribe to my channel if you, because I'm trying to figure out how this subscription system actually helps you gain viewers. Not that I want to be rich, but this is costing me quite a lot of time over the last few months. Let's get going, because I wanted to point a few things out for what happened last this year and what might happen in the future. So first thing I wanted to do, and that's why I did a split screen, is that I wanted to point out some of the other admins in the Facebook group. So if you're not part of Facebook, which is totally fine, then these few minutes will be lost on you. But I promise in the second half of the video I'll give you five small tips what to do on my A7R4, which I really really like, but I still have adapted, and I want to point a few things out if you haven't seen them before. So the first, let's talk about the different admins. So basically what happened about a little bit over a year ago, a person called Lee Barrel posted a message on one of the A7 III groups that he found this group to become less and less interesting, because there was a lot of posting about boxes and images, and he wanted to set up his own group. And I think within a few hours I reacted, hey, I'm more than willing to help you. So over the year basically he made me also an admin at some point. So we are the two admins. I am the one that's doing most of the talking and most of the being actively to the outside, but both Lee and the others, so Andy, Rich and Eric, they post a lot less than I do, and they scream a lot less than I do, but they are doing in the background quite a lot of work. So my first thanks I'll go out to them for helping me and helping us, because I consider us a community, us both on YouTube but especially on Facebook, where we are trying to help each other. Hopefully this background is not distracting you too much, but it's let's say part of the part of the year. I can't find the word for it. Anyway, so these are the admins and the moderators, and even then I have to, as far as I can see, the work is getting more, but it's more about approving people than it is about really keeping check on people, because there's quite a few people, and I won't name them by name because I think they're, quite a few people sort of pointing other people in the right direction. And what we wanted from the beginning is that this would become a self sort of steering group, where people sort of nicely and gently push each other into the correct direction. So what you see is what we do. For example, if somebody posts an image which we really don't really approve of, we won't delete it right away. We might put a comment there, hey, it's a really nice image, but please next time don't do this, because there's more than enough groups that are for that, and please do it in another place. The same with some of the other questions, or if people go over the boundary, we will try to figure out if it makes sense, and in this way sort of steer the group in the correct direction that we, and if I say we are now with 11,000 people, we kind of like. So sometimes you see me asking, hey, what do people think about this? This is why we are doing this. So the work on, I think, let's say censoring the group or kicking people out or other adjustment is not that much work. What is a little bit of work and becoming more work is simply how many people want to join. So I made a setup today a little bit more difficult, so I need to play with some buttons, but you can see that there's on average now about 200 or 300 people waiting to be approved. And actually we approve everybody by hand, so we check everything if people answer the questions, and there are still many questions, people that don't answer the most important question if they agree with the rules, and then we actually refuse them. I would guess about half of the people are refused at the moment. So that's a pity, but that's what it is. So at this moment, 237 people are waiting to be approved. So, and even then, I did this kind of on purpose. Today we had 11,111 members. I just stopped approving them, so we got this nice sort of number. But you can see that that's quite a lot of people that's joining. There's now about probably between 100 and 200 people joining each week. So the fact that it's still not getting messy quickly, and no ads and no unboxing and not too much questions about lenses and other things is really up to you guys following the rules and correcting other people. Quite happy about that. So hopefully in the next few years that will continue like that, we can grow even further. Also an important change that we made over the last few months is when the A7 R4 came out, and I own one, which will be the second part of this video, a few more tips. I kind of wanted to, well, I don't want to rename the group, I don't want to leave the group, because it would be kind of weird. So we opened it up for all the full frame cameras, and I think that's also working out quite well. That means we are getting in more and more people, but so far it's not been too much of a mess, so I think that's also worked out okay. But feel free, either on the Facebook group, at the top there's a posting called Rules. If you have comments about it or things that you think we should change, please do. Sorry for the YouTube only people. I totally respect if you don't want to be part of Facebook, then this part is kind of not for you. But let's get back to, because so thank you. Have a really wonderful 2020. I know that I've made some friends over the last year, and I will show you a little bit about that when I'm talking about some of the things that I'm going to work on next year. Thank you, and have a wonderful 2020 to the other admins and the moderators, but also all the members who help each other out. I think it's a wonderful place to be. Also on the YouTube channel, we don't have like 10,000 of members, but that's fine. Maybe we'll grow up to 5,000 or 10,000, who knows. I don't want to make this my job. That's, I already have a job, which clearly is related to the stuff behind me. It's a fun job, I have to admit. If you want to join, subscribe, please do. So let's get back to a little bit more relaxing view. So first thing to make this a little bit more of a useful a bonus part of this video, I do want to point out that I'm quite happy with my A7 R4, so I'm answering a lot of questions and also defending it in a way, but I did make some changes, or I'm still doing some changes, and I wanted to point out a few, and especially two companies, or one company and also one person, which actually I have not talked to for a while, but I noticed when I was putting this on that I do use three of his products I want to share with you. So first, this is now my A7R 4. A7R 3 kind of looks the same, but it has a special prototype on there from the company called Smallrig. So I'm not showing you that just yet. But I wanted to point out four things or five things that I still do on my camera and which might help you. The first, L-Wear kit. Now the good news is Smallrig was extremely nice to me over the last year. They actually invited me over, and most people probably know this, to China. And if I put it up, you can see it's quite a big sort of heavy thing. They invited me to China, and again, it's not really about this present or this award that they gave me. They gave me lots of presents, so they invited me for a week to come over. So yes, I'm biased because I'm helping them design. They don't pay for that, but they did invite me over to China and paid for my trip and most of my stay. So that was extremely nice, and I would almost say as a result, because now I feel guilty, I will double my effort in designing some really cool stuff together with Smallrig in the next year. And two of them are already quite far in progress, and I'm itching to tell you about them, but I can't just yet. So thanks to the people at Smallrig for giving me this, but especially the nice week we had in Shenzhen in China. Yeah, something that I will remember for a long time, because it's kind of different to visit a company and people you've been working with than just visiting let's say a vacation location. Again, this is kind of distracting. Next time this will be the more relaxing background. So this is the L bracket, right? So I think if you don't have one, the whole idea is about a pinky grip. You will find lots of reviews on my channel still used on the A7R4. I'm actually using a hectotype that I made myself based on the A7 R3 version. And I don't think I'm saying something weird that we are using, or we have been using this as sort of let's say a concept idea for the next grip that might come out for the A7 R4 and the A7 R3, etc, etc. So if you like L-Bracket, Smallrig is a really fun company to use. So the next thing, of course nobody's paying for this except you by clicking on here. The next thing that I added, which was I will also link it in the description, but I have a review, is a bigger EVF hood. And the reason I did it, it was to figure out it would be help with my glasses. But what I found out is that, especially with some of the new modes on the A7 R4, where you now have this touch to track, right? So if you turn it on, you can now sort of touch to track to see it will automatically start tracking that part. Oh, let me put the. Oh, by the way. My videos won't get any more professional in the next year. I promise you that. They will still be as messy and too long, etc, etc. But you can see, if it's able to focus, that it should focus on that object. And you can now do push to focus. But what I notice, at least on the R4, that normally if my nose would hit it, it would not really distract the movement. But it seems to do that a little bit more. So for me, having this bigger, somewhat deeper EVF hood on there actually means that my nose is not touching the screen as easy anymore. So that means that the whole tracking is working a little bit better. So also still put it on there. Yeah, and I will leave it on there. The third thing I want to show you is this button. So you can see them, they're also on my lenses. They are from a company called Shutter Bands. Again, I will link them in the description. They send them to me for free. I have not talked to him for a while, but three of the products I'm showing are actually on this camera. Now, for the A7 R3, he made these buttons that you can put on top of all your keys. With the A7 R4, for me, the buttons, especially this one, the AF on button, is now perfect. Sony, I think, totally nailed the buttons now, in my view. So no need for that. But for me personally, the shutter button, I still prefer to have a little bit of a button on there. So I'll put one on there again. I'm not sure what they cost. I think the whole package is about $12 or $13. Dollars, and then you have different things in there, which includes one other item I will show you. But I still like this button on there. I would prefer it not to be like Leica red, but that's just me. But for now, they're only in a red, and yeah, I use them. I like them a lot. So the second one, also again from the same company, is these rings. So these are little rubbers that you can put on your E-mount lenses. And you can sort of, you see them already roll into the mount ridge. And what is nice about that is that you can protect extra protection for dust and water. Now, water I don't think is a big issue because most of your lenses will be sealed, at least the ones that I'm using. But I don't think you should trust it for that. But what is nice is the dust part. So normally what might happen is dust would come into the ring, and if you open it up, then you sort of might get some dust in there. And I found these little rings quite an interesting solution for that by the same company. So the last one in the quick one is quite a recent one. So yesterday I could finally it took a few days more, but last week I reviewed the Tough Cards from Sony, and there was some discussion if they would fit, yes or no. And to be fair, maybe the new ones are a little bit thinner, or maybe I'm just more careful. I'm not sure what's up with that. But for me, they have been working fine, but they are sometimes a little bit more fiddly to get in. I think it has to do with the edge, which I will show you. But the same company, so Shutter Benz, is also selling these little flaps, and let me pry it out a little bit. You can see, maybe better from this angle, you can see that there are these little flaps there. It's really difficult now to sort of show you, but they are these little flaps that you can put on your cards, and that makes it easier to get them out, and for two reasons. Please do not pull really hard on them because you will break them. I don't think so far what I found with the Tough Cards, they are not more difficult to get out, but they are a little bit more tricky. I know that sounds like a contradiction, but I don't think it is. What I mean, you should not pull on them any harder than you would do with your normal cards. But there is some trick to it that you need to push a little bit when you're taking them out. So, and this makes it a lot easier if you have something to pull on. So press it, and now I can sort of push a little bit to that side and get it out, right? Because I think one of the issues is that if you look at them, there's a little bit of a ridge over here. And I think part of the problem is that if you try to really pull them out quickly, you sort of hit something on the side, and that might damage something. Because as you can clearly see, for me, let me put it back in. I should put the camera a little bit up like this. But if I put it back in, if you do it with a little bit of tender love, that you can see there's no problem. But now with this little flap, it's easier to press it and push it a little bit while you are pulling it out. If you feel that is going not easy enough, yes, put it back a little bit and do it again. But as you can see, I'm hardly using any pressure to put these cards in or pulling them out. It's just be a little bit more careful in the whole process. So let me also do the card number two. You let it jump out, press it. See, this one is now going a little bit more difficult, so I do it again. Not by pulling really hard, but just by doing it back and doing it up again. But you can see that these little tabs that he made, that you just sort of, there's some sticky tape there. You can add them, and then they are fine. Oops, they're a tough car, so they should be able to survive a drop like this. So put it back in, and there they are. Of course, now you have to sort of, if you close them up, push it down a little bit, but there it goes. Let's see if the camera wakes up and finds both cards again. Why is it turned off? So let me put on the display. Oops, put on display. Yeah, the card is still happy, so let's take a picture. Okay, that's it. So thank you for watching and have a wonderful 2020. If you have ideas about this channel or if you have ideas about the Facebook group, yeah, please post them here or on Facebook and we'll get back to you. And thank you for watching and see you in the next one. Bye bye.